What's up guys, my name is Ace, and welcome back to another Gun Guide. This is a series where I go into great detail with all of the stats of every one of the weapons in Black Ops 4 multiplayer. In today's episode, we're going to be moving on to the third LMG, and this is the VKM 750. First up, as always, let's have a look at the damage, and the VKM deals 54 damage within any range you'll be able to realistically find within Black Ops 4 multiplayer. This means in core game modes, it's always going to be a 3-shot kill, and in hardcore, it's always going to be a 1-shot kill unless the enemy has armor or unless you're shooting through something. Our rate of fire is quite slow at 361 rounds per minute, but we can bump that up to 400 rounds per minute with rapid fire. This means our statistical minimum time to kill without any attachments equipped, so we don't have rapid fire on this, is going to be 332 milliseconds, which is very solid, especially when you consider the fact that this applies to all ranges that you'll be able to find on these maps. Now our absolute minimum time to kill potential with the VKM, this is with attachments, so with the high caliber attachments, which we'll get into in a little bit, as well as rapid fire. This is one of the fastest killing guns in the game at just 150 milliseconds. So just looking at the raw damage as well as the time to kill statistics of this gun, it is extremely powerful in these areas. As for armor, the VKM, just like with pretty much every other gun in the game, will take one extra shot to kill an armored user, assuming you're shooting them in the body. Now this is a little bit unfortunate with this gun because since it has a slow fire rate, the moment you're taking that one extra shot to kill, your time to kill value will plummet quite a bit. And when the game first launched, the VKM was actually over the threshold where it dealt so much damage that it wouldn't even matter if the enemy had armor. This no longer applies to the VKM. As for ranges, like I said at the beginning, with the VKM, it will be a 3-shot kill within any practical line of sight you'll be able to find within these multiplayer maps. Same thing goes with hardcore game modes. It will be a 1-shot kill at all ranges unless you're shooting through something or unless the enemy has armor or boosted health from crash. Moving on to headshots, we get a standard headshot multiplier of 1.1, which takes our headshot damage to a 59. This means that standard headshots without any attachments equipped on this are useless to you unless you happen to be challenging somebody that has armor and you're hitting all of the shots to the head. With high caliber, on the other hand, we can change this a little bit. Keep in mind, with the VKM, we have access to both high caliber 1 as well as high caliber 2, so you can extend this zone into the upper chest as well. And the multiplier for this is 1.4, which takes our high caliber damage profile to a 75. And what this means is 2 shots to a high caliber zone will be a kill instead of 3. And this is how you get that insane time to kill potential of 150 milliseconds, assuming you're also running rapid fire. It's about 167 milliseconds if you aren't running rapid fire. So the high caliber attachments on this gun are insanely powerful, and I highly recommend that you use them. This brings us to hipfire, and as you can see here, it's got the same hipfire as the Hades and a slightly better hipfire potential than the Titan, but at the end of the day, it is an LMG and therefore it does have a relatively wide hipfire spread. For idle sway, as you can see here, the idle sway is practically non-existent on the VKM. It's very, very stable when you're aiming down sight. This brings us to recoil, and as you can see, the VKM is very accurate. It does bounce around a little bit, some side-to-side bounce as well as some slight vertical bounce, but generally speaking, you're going to be able to remain quite accurate even at longer ranges. As for the recoil with rapid fire, you can see that there is a little bit more bounce than without rapid fire, but not a massive difference by any means. You still maintain quite good accuracy with the rapid fire attachment. And finally, this brings us to the recoil with the grip attached, and as you can see here, it is practically pinpoint accurate if you're using grip. Moving on to our magazine capacity, it's quite good, especially when you consider the rate of fire of this gun. At 50 rounds with 150 total starting ammo, it does take you quite some time to burn through 50 rounds. But with extended mags, we can increase that up to 66 rounds with 198 total starting ammo. As for our reload add time, this is very slow, but then again, it is an LMG, so we kind of expect this, at 5.27 seconds. This is the slowest in the LMG category, but we can use the fast mag attachment on this, and that will reduce your reload add time all the way down to 2.12 seconds, which is an absolutely insane improvement to your reload time. This brings us to our handling and mobility stats. For our aim down sight time, this is very slow at 350 milliseconds, but with quick draw, we can cut that all the way down to 250 milliseconds, which is respectable. And our sprint out time is also quite slow at 350 milliseconds, but with the Gung Ho perk, we can reduce that down to approximately 230 milliseconds, or if we just break our sprint by aiming down sight while using Gung Ho, then we will be able to fire immediately. As for our movement speed, once again, I was quite surprised to see that it has the same movement speed as the other LMGs, but also the assault rifles and the tactical rifles at 95%. I honestly thought the VKM was going to be the slowest in the category, but it's not. It's got a solid movement speed. And we actually see a similar story with our aim down sight stray speed. As long as we aren't firing our gun, we get an aim down sight stray speed of 40%. But just like with the Titan, the moment you pull the trigger and start firing that gun while aiming down sight, your movement speed will slow down significantly and you'll pretty much be locked in place. So those are all the important stats for the VKM, but we also have an operator mod for this gun, and let's get into that one. This mod is called the Fat Barrel, and with this, you fire massive shells that hit their targets easier. So presumably based on this description, it allows you to slightly miss your target and still get a hit on them. On paper, this sounds ridiculously powerful, but let's have a look at my testing. As you can see here, with the Fat Barrel equipped, I can slightly miss my target in some areas and still get a hit on them. However, it's definitely not an extreme amount. You still have to be practically touching your target in order to get that hit. But at first glance, when you're looking at this, it seems like the Fat Barrel is definitely helping you a noticeable amount, and it gives you sort of a little halo around your enemies that you can still shoot and get damage with. However, have a look at my testing when I'm not using the Fat Barrel. It may be very slightly less forgiving, but as you can see, you still have the ability to get a hit on the enemy if you are slightly outside of their character model. And this is nothing new to a lot of first-person shooters out there. The hitboxes will often extend very slightly past the character model. And that's just because everybody has the same hitbox, and some character models are skinnier, like Sarah for instance. She is skinnier looking than Torque for instance, but they have the same hitboxes. So realistically speaking, after testing the Fat Barrel, there really isn't that much of a noticeable difference. Perhaps a few pixels here or there, but honestly, I really don't feel like the Fat Barrel attachment is worth it on this gun. I've seen a lot of people absolutely swear by this, but based on the tests, it appears a lot of what they're experiencing is simply placebo. Now, of course, if you guys think that the Fat Barrel does something else or that my testing is flawed here, feel free to let me know down below, but based on everything I can see, it's definitely not worth using 3 of your Pick 10 class points. So now let's move on to the other attachments for the VKM. For optics, I really feel this gun has decent enough iron sights that you don't need an optic, but having said that, a lot of times you're challenging people at longer ranges, so it's nice to have a bit more of a clear picture. Typically, I'll just use a reflex sight, but honestly, you can't go wrong with any of these optics. For the other attachments though, I really feel these attachments are very important with the VKM. First up, like I said earlier, the High Caliber 1 as well as High Caliber 2 attachments are very important. This will give you a ridiculous time to kill advantage over most of the people in the game. Grip is kind of nice, you guys could see the improvement that you had with grip earlier, but I also feel like it's not really necessary. You're generally quite accurate with this gun anyways. Quick draw is quite important if you're trying to be even somewhat aggressive and not just hanging back towards the backside of the map. Extended mags, I feel, is completely unnecessary with this gun simply because its lower fire rate means that 50 round standard magazine will last you a decent amount of time before you needing to reload. Rapid fire, I always treat as kind of a bonus attachment. If I happen to have that extra class point, sure, I'll pop on rapid fire, but generally speaking, I don't feel like it's necessary. And finally, fast mags is another one of those attachments where it's kind of a bonus. It is a nice attachment to have, but you shouldn't be reloading too often with this gun, and therefore it's not necessary by any means. So finally, let's get into a couple great example classes I have for you guys with the VKM. This first one is amazing at winning gunfights. You will be absolutely dominant as long as you're hitting your shots. With this, we're stacking up pretty heavily on attachments. With this, we have both High Caliber 1 as well as High Caliber 2 and Rapid Fire, so we get that insane time to kill potential. And we also have Quick Draw equipped, which allows us to be a bit more aggressive. That way we don't have the crazy slow aim down sight time, so if we run into somebody and we're not pre-aiming, we still have a very good chance in that gunfight with Quick Draw. Our gear is going to be Stim Shot so we can remain aggressive, and our equipment is going to be Special Issue. This leaves us 2 points for perks, and we're going to go with my personal crutches. We have Gung Ho as well as Dead Silence. Gung Ho is so we don't have to deal with that really, really long sprint out time. If we break our sprint by aiming down sight, we can start firing immediately, which is awesome in close quarters. And with Dead Silence, I hate hearing my own footsteps. I also hate showing up on enemies' acoustic sensors, and therefore that's why I love using Dead Silence. This is definitely my favorite VKM class to use because it allows me to be somewhat aggressive, which is my natural playstyle, and as long as I'm hitting my shots, I'm pretty much unstoppable with this. As for the second example class I have for you guys, this one's designed a bit more for hanging back, locking down lanes, and picking people off from a distance. It's an excellent counter-sniper class, and with this we're using a reflex sight just to give us a bit more clarity at range. We've got, once again, both of those high caliber attachments because it pretty much just cuts your time to kill in half, which is extremely valuable. And we've got grip on here, so we've got that pinpoint accuracy. That way, if we have an enemy that's on a piece of cover across the map, you'll still be able to pick them off very, very easily, and you won't be missing your shots. For our secondary, we have a launcher, so this will allow us to support the team as well, because if you're going to be hanging back, at least shoot down some UAVs and help the team out, which will also help us towards our score streaks. Which brings us to the next part of our class. This is the ComSec device, which allows us to get our streaks up faster. Once again, for our equipment, it's going to be Special Issue, and for our perks, we've got Engineer as well as Cool-Blooded. These perks are just designed to support that sort of anti-score streak role that you use with this class, and I really find that this class works very effectively as a support role. And with that, we're gonna wrap up today's gun guide. Personally, the VKM I really feel is a super underrated gun. I rarely run into this in lobbies, yet it is extremely powerful and has so much potential behind it. Of course though, I'd like to know in the comment section below, what do you guys think of the VKM? Do you agree with me? Do you think it is an underrated gun or underappreciated gun? Or do you just not like it? Let me know what you guys are thinking down below. Also, if you guys have missed any of the previous episodes of Gun Guides, I will leave a link to the playlist down below. If you enjoyed the video, a like rating is always appreciated, and don't forget to subscribe for more if you haven't already. I'll talk to you guys next time.